How y'all doing? Peace. That's y'all expecting me to do magic or something, right? See, I come from a strange background. From the South originally. My father is a Muslim, and look how quiet everybody got. Oh, that's all right then. Father's a Muslim. My grandmother's a born again Christian. So you know, it was a wild thing going on in my childhood. You know, 1969, my father joined the Nation of Islam, which was cool for him, but basically just fucked me out all the holidays because I was 6 years old, and you don't understand that when you're six. And my grandmother wasn't trying to help me understand it either. She just freaked out. The baby can't have no Christmas? What you mean that child can't have a Christmas? It's Christmas time. Oh, no, baby, you come with me. I don't care what your father's doing. I'm taking you to see Santa Claus. My grandmother take me to see Santa Claus. I sit on Santa's lap. So what do you want for Christmas, little boy? My father's in the corner. Tell him you want your freedom. You got the freedom in that bag, fat man? You know, when I was six, you know, I was like, well, I thought I wanted some Rock'em Sock'em Robots, but guess I want some freedom, Santa, because Bab over here is running my life. I didn't know. You don't know when you're six. You know, my father's job, he was going around finding plots against the black race, no matter how cleverly hidden he could find it. My father would find plots in a grocery store. Walk through the store, pointing at things. Look at this, son. You got to ask yourself questions. Ask yourself, why must I be cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs? The black cereal make you crazy? You see, the Frosted Flakes, they're white, they're great. Cocoa Puffs make you nutty. I don't understand that. You see, that's just regular rice, but it's black, so they call it wild rice. What's so wild about it? The jumping off the shelf hit no ladies in the head? I don't think so. So I grew up with that. I go home now, you know, it's like a little holy war going on in the house. My grandmother's still a Christian. My grandmother's crazy. She's 92 years old. I'm my only child. She wants to see me married. You know, grandmother's 92. She gives me advice on how to pick up women. Don't man, it's all to go to church, baby. That's what you need to do. Go back to that church. It's a lot of good girls up in the church. My grandmother wants me to work the church. You know, use the church to pick up women. That's wrong, ain't it? So we walk through the church. Hey, how you doing? Excuse me for a second. Praise the Lord. Look. I ain't here for that. What you reading? Oh, yeah, I read that. Yeah. And a guy comes back in there, and it's pretty wild. Look, I'm going to go over here and get some of this wine. Wine and crack. It's right over here in the corner. You want some? That's what Granny wants. They all want something, you know. The grandparents, I have uncles, they all crazy. Like my father, when I go home, he makes me watch tapes. I had to watch this tape of this guy, Tom Metzger. You ever seen him, Tom Metzger? King of the white supremacists. You should be aware of this man. He is an idiot. He is. You know, and not only is he an idiot, he's funny. You know, his whole thing, I saw him on a talk show once, and so I stood up and said, Mr. Metzger, what makes you think you're superior to all people of color? Well, look at all the things white people have invented. We invented the airplane, we invented the telephone, we, like white people had a caucus somewhere. Like they got together and said, you know, genetically any one of us can do this, but to save time, Bell, why don't you put a phone together? You two Wright brothers, put a plane together, something in your spare time, anything. It don't make sense. You know, basically what he's saying is the whole premise of white supremacy is if somebody from your race does something, then you're magically endowed with the same ability. It's hogwash, you see. Because if it's true, I'd like to see Mr. Metzger have a heart attack. You know, because you know the first man to perform open heart surgery was black. So, you know. As he had his attack, I could just sort of walk through the crowd. Excuse me, you want to back up, please? Get this man some room. Oh, are you a doctor? No. But I am black. And me and this busboy here, the only two people that can save this man's life. Hand me a steak knife, buddy. Let's go to work. That's all we could do. Hey, y'all, be good to each other. Thanks a lot for listening to me. I'm out of here.